scholarly articles, academic articles, peer-reviewed articles. You may have heard these terms used by your professor, but what the heck do they mean? Essentially, these are different ways of describing the same thing: research articles that have been published in scholarly journals. But what is a research article, and how does it get published in a scholarly journal? Research articles are written by scholars and report their research practices and findings. They have an audience of other researchers. In order to be published in a scholarly journal and accepted by the scholarly community, the article must pass several quality tests. The most important of these tests is called peer review. So, what is peer review? We can get a better understanding of the role of peer review if we look at the academic publishing process as a whole. This is Rosa. Rosa is a researcher. In this case, a chemist, but researchers come in many forms. Her job is to come up with ideas and then run experiments to test them. Rosa discovers something new and wants to share this discovery with the academic community. To do this, she writes a draft article describing her research and findings and submits it for publication in a scholarly journal, hoping they will publish it. The journal's editor reads over Rosa's article to decide if it's a good fit for the journal. If it is, the editor sends copies of the article to a group of experts to evaluate the article's quality in a process called peer review. Each reviewer evaluates Rosa's article by asking questions to judge the quality and significance of the research. Questions like, is this research important? Is the methodology sound? Are the conclusions logical? Are the findings original? They respond to the editor and recommend approval for Rosa's article. However, they do suggest some revisions, but this is very common. The editor has the final decision, and she decides to accept the peer reviewer's recommendations and publish Rosa's article in the journal. Rejection is common, though. Some journals reject more than 90% of the submissions they receive. From the time Rosa first submits her draft article to the time it is finally published, several months or years may have elapsed. Once the journal is published, it is made available to subscribers, which are usually university libraries. Libraries, like this one, provide online or print access to the journal. Over time, libraries build up years of access to a journal and its articles. Because there are so many journals and articles, it can be hard to find the articles that are most useful to you, such as Rosa's. To help you search through it all, use a library database. The database's search tools allow you to quickly find articles that match your needs. You may also uncover other articles that are useful to you. Just like there are many journals, there are many databases. Some will list Rosa's article, and others won't. If you're not sure which database to use or how to find articles effectively, ask a librarian.